abuse is the focus of a new pilot program that Baltimore City's police commissioner revealed tonight. That's after several of the members of an anti-abuse commission, animal abuse commission, resigned this past May, saying there was no support at City Hall. That's where 11 News reporter George Lettuce is to tell us now what happened at tonight's public hearing. George joins us live. George?
Well, Rod, tonight's hearing was gave a city council a chance to get an update on where the city stands on this issue in light of that recent controversy involving the Anti-Animal Abuse Commission.
Baltimore City's been the scene of a number of horrific animal abuse cases, enough that the city set up an Anti-Animal Abuse Commission in 2010. But this spring, five of its members, including President Caroline Griffin, resigned over frustration, alleging city agencies showed little interest in the commission and the fight against animal abuse.
It doesn't matter how good your foot soldiers are if they lack support from their generals. And without it, new initiatives will amount to nothing more than window dressing.
But at a public hearing before City Council Wednesday, the health commissioner, who oversees animal control, and the police commissioner pledged that their agencies take animal abuse seriously. In fact, Police Commissioner Anthony Batts announced a pilot program. He's assigned one of his lieutenant colonels to oversee what's described as a 24/7 animal abuse response team of canine officers who he says are being trained to have additional investigative skills.
Just in how to deal with animal type injuries and investigate those type of cases.
Police leadership also promised it will work on giving more response priority for animal cruelty 911 calls.
If the citizens are descriptive in their call, then I think that call would be immediately dispatched.
I think there's a lot of confusion about how these cases are going to be handled going forward. I mean, I'm encouraged that people are finally addressing the problems. We're hopeful that these cases will get the attention they deserve.
And City Council plans to hold another hearing in about 3 months to get an update on this pilot program. We're live at City Hall. George Lettuce, WBAL-TV 11 News.